Hi students, last class we learned how to identify the carbohydrates in food materials, correct? So today I am going to explain identification of proteins and the identification of fats in food materials, okay? So we know that carbohydrate, proteins, fats are the macronutrients, okay? We need essential nutrients to our body, okay? So identification of proteins. Protein, why we have to take a protein? The food which contain protein as a nutrient, we can say as a body building nutrient. Why? Because protein is very, very essential to our body to grow, development and the repair of damaged parts of body. Okay? So that's why we need protein. If all the food contains protein, no. Some of the variety of food contains protein, not all the food. For example, cereals, grains, legumes, like beans, meat, if you take these food items only contains protein as a nutrient. Okay, so these contain how we can say that means some simple test. Doing some simple test, we can recognize the food item whether contain protein or not. So let us start with our test identification test for protein. Okay, so for this test, we need some requirements. They are test tubes, copper sulfate solution, that is CuSO4 formula. Caustic soda solution is nothing but sodium hydroxide solution and a droppers. Okay, so here copper sulfate is a solid, but we need solution. How we have to prepare, we will take solution means, we can prepare copper sulfate solution by adding 2 grams of copper sulfate in 100 ml of water, then we can obtain copper sulfate solution. Same as caustic soda. Caustic soda is nothing but sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is readily available in solid form. So that's why we will make solution. How we will prepare sodium hydroxide solution or caustic soda solution? By using 1 gram of sodium hydroxide flakes solid in 100 ml of water, then we can make sodium hydroxide or caustic soda solution. Okay, and a dropper. Okay, so dropper is like the structure. Already in last class I showed some pictures also how the test tube will look like, how the droppers will look like. Okay, so here let us start our test for protein. First you take few quantity of food sample to be tested for proteins. Suppose if you take in solid sample, you have to grind or powder that sample and you immediately transfer into test tube, clean dry test tube. Then afterwards, the solid you have to dissolve in water. That's why you add 10 drops of water to that solid sample. Then you make a sample solution. If you can't dissolve, you should shake for some time. Then it will dissolve. Then our sample solution is ready to test. Afterwards, CuSO4 solution already we prepared. So 2 drops of copper sulfate solution. Add to the sample solution by using dropper. Afterwards, shake well. Afterwards, 2 drops of sodium hydroxide solution also added to the sample solution by using dropper. Then you just shake well and a few seconds you just keep one side. And you can observe the clear identification. The color will change into, violet color. So the violet color solution indicates the presence of protein in that particular food. Understand? So first take a few quantity of food sample to be tested. If you take a solid, you grind and powder the sample and you pour into your test tube. Then add few drops of water to dissolve. Afterwards, by using dropper, you add 2 drops of copper sulfate solution to the sample solution. Then add sodium hydroxide solution, 2 drops to the sample solution by using dropper. Then shake well. Afterwards, you can observe the clear identification violet color it will give. So the violet color indicates the presence of protein in food. Understood? Next, identification test for fats. So already in previous class I said energy giving food are carbohydrates and fats. So fat is an energy giving nutrient. The which food contains fat, that food we can say as an energy giving food. For example, fat, milk, some oils like a coconut, okay, these all contains fats. How we will do these identification test for fats? You need some food sample, which food you want to test, and butter paper or filter paper. Okay, so it's very simple test. Okay, first you take a few quantity of solid sample, and you take butter paper or filter paper, and you just place that sample on paper medium. Then fold the paper, and a few minutes after you open and remove that sample from on that paper, then you just dry for a few minutes, and you can clearly observe a patch, transparent patch, oily stain will appear on the butter paper or filter paper. This transient strain indicates the presence of fat in that particular food item. Okay, so this is the identification test for fats. So we observed identification test for carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. So the macronutrients are carbohydrates, proteins, fats. These three are very, very essential to our body for growth and development and energy. So how we are using? What are the need of these nutrients? Next class I am going to explain. Okay? If you have any doubts, ask through WhatsApp. Thank you.